Hi, welcome to another video from Equaser.com. In this video we are going to use a Casio FX-991ES Plus calculator to do the complex calculations. So let's get started. For the complex calculation we have to go into complex mode by pressing this mode button and then selecting number 2, pressing number 2 to CMPLX, which is complex. So now on the screen you will see CMPLX, which is complex, so we know that this is in complex mode. So for the complex we have usually a value, let's say 8 plus 5i. So this is a real part and this is imaginary part. In some calculations, in some books, you might see as j, but doesn't matter, so I here is imaginary, so if it's j, just replace it by I in this calculator. So let's enter this one into calculator, 8 plus 5, and then for I we press this ENG button, which has the label I here. So that's how we enter it. If I press enter, you will see it here. This button now has another job here. When I press it, it brings the real at the top and the imaginary at the bottom. In the next few steps, you will see this feature is very useful, and I will show you. The other way, so this is a So this is a polar form. So this is a polar form, but sometimes you will see it as a vector form with a magnitude and angle. Let's say you will have 4 and then angle 36 degrees. So to enter a value in degree, we must be in degree mode here. So by pressing the shift mode and then press number 3, which is degree. Now we are in degree, we enter by pressing 4, and then for the angle we press this minus sign inside the parenthesis by pressing the shift. So 4 angle 36 equal sign. So this is entered, and you can add and do a little calculation, but on the screen, as you can see, it has already been converted into the polar form. So this is the x value, and then plus this is the imaginary value. This is the real and imaginary. This arrow shows that I can go to the right to see the I, but here is the beauty of this button. By pressing this button, real value goes up and the imaginary comes here. So we did two things, immediately converted, and also we were able to enter the value as well. Another element that you need in the calculation is the argument. Let's say you have an argument of 8 plus 5i. So the argument of this one is actually the angle of the value. So we have another menu here, which is called complex menu. This menu will be accessed by pressing the shift button, shift and then 2. So you will see we have here another menu, number 1, which is argument. So argument of 8 plus 5, and then I press I automatically. So close that. So it will tell me that the argument of that one is 32.05. Don't forget, this is in degree. So if I shift and then 4, I make this in radian. Now if I plus equal sign, you will see that this is 0.558 radian. Very important that we have to have the right setting for our calculations. Okay, now the other way to convert from one form to the other form, from the polar form into the vector form, so you enter the value 8 plus 5i, then go to the complex menu. I will mention a lot about this complex menu by pressing shift and 2, and here it shows that we want in this format, which we press number 4, a plus bi. So on the screen you see this value goes to this format, plus press equal sign. So 8 plus 5i, shift, we go to this complex menu. I will refer to this a lot, so remember it, the complex menu, and we want it into the vector form with the r radius or magnitude and the angle. Okay, as you can see here, it shows in the other form, it shows 89 and then angle 0.558. This is in radian, so pressing this button will help us to see it properly, the magnitude, and then this is the angle. If I shift and go to mode and make it degree, now you see that it's 32. Okay, so many times you need also to have the conjugate of a value. Let's say the same value, let's get the conjugate of it. The conjugate of this one is just change of sign, but during the calculation you want to have this value and then the conjugate of it. So we will have 8 plus 5. So sorry, to get the conjugate of it, let's go to the complex menu, conj, number 2, press number 2, and then 8 plus 5i, close it, and that will give you the conjugate, which is the sign has changed. Now, let's say you have 5 plus 6i, and then you have 3 minus 5.9i, and then you have 6 over 4 plus 2i minus 5.1i. So we can use the memory to make our life easy to do calculations. Some questions have multiple steps, and for those calculations in electrical engineering and some other courses, you will need to use the same value over and over again. So the best way would be to enter all these values into the memory. So let's call, I'm going to store this. So we have this red color or the memory A, B, C, D, E, F, X, Y, and M. These are all the available memories, 8 memories, so you can store 8 different complex values. So I'm going to store this into A, and this one into B, and this one into C. Let's store them and then use them. So 5 plus 6i, and then to access all these red, I have to activate the store. Store is activated by shift. So I press shift, store. Now you see STO on the screen. So this is now waiting to press. If I press any of those memory, this value will go into that memory. So I'm pressing A now. As you can see, it shows this value is into A. All clear, AC. Let's go enter the other value, which is 3 minus 5.9i. And now this one into B. Shift, store, B. Now this is stored into B. And look, it has changed it to fraction. And then for the C, this is also a good practice. So press 6, this line, and then underneath 4 plus 2i, and the denominator 4 plus 2i. With this arrow, go to the right, minus 5.1, minus 5.1. and then I. So this one, shift store C. So this went into C. Now the value is here. How can we recall it? Just press RCL, which is recall A. If I press recall A, the value is here. Recall B, that's the value. Recall C, that's the value. It has already been done some calculation over it, or if you see it, 1.2 minus 5.7, that's the sum of this value. Let's say you have an equation, something like A plus B conjugate multiplied by C. So this calculator can do exact this way except for the conjugate. So open parenthesis, recall A plus, now we have to go to the complex menu to bring the conjugate, complex and then 2, which is conjugate, and then put recall B. So B is here, close the conjugate, and then close the main one, multiply by recall C. So A plus conjugate of B times C equal, this is a value. If you don't like it, a fraction, press this to convert it into 77.43 minus 31.32 I. So this is how you do the complex calculation with this calculator. I hope you've learned something from this tutorial. If you like it, please thumb up. And also, if you have not subscribed to my channel, please do so now. Thank you.